Hi there, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whenever you're coming to this practice. Today is a grounding and gratitude practice. Beautiful practice to use any time of the month, anytime you feel just a little imbalanced or you just want to get centered. This is a great one to really incorporate during your weeks, months, or during the day. So you will need blocks as well as a blanket or pillows. Whatever you have on hand is perfectly fine. All right, we'll go ahead and get started. So coming to the mat, we'll begin with our birthing of the meditation. And so taking both soles, right, placing them underneath the shins. And of course, if you tend to round in the shoulders and have a little discomfort, you can always take the blanket or a pillow, even a block, and just place it right underneath the tailbone. All right. So today's mantra, I would like to invite you to use this mantra or affirmation. It says, when I receive abundance, I welcome it with pure gratitude. So we'll begin to start the meditation by going within. So crown of the head in line with the spine. Gently allow the shoulders to fall away from the ears. Slightly tucking the chin. And as you bring the eyes to a soft gaze or gently close the eyelids, go ahead, take a deep inhale. Through the nose, notice the belly expand. Exhale out of the mouth. We'll do two more of those. Inhale. Exhale. Collectively together, last breath. Inhale. And exhale. Gently bring palms right at the center, right? So bringing big pinkies to touch and thumbs to touch, and the rest of the fingers are fanned out. So this is the Lotus Mudra, which helps with receiving, right? So the fingertips are right at the heart space, right? So whatever you received in, allow it to pour into the heart. Inhale. Exhale. And just take a moment to notice what it feels like to receive. What is that experience for you? Is there any resistance in receiving? Fear. Fear that what you receive is not enough. Is there a mental chatter saying that you're not worth receiving? And do you feel as though there's obligation? Of abundance. As you continue breathing, just notice the sensations in the body. Shame. Inhale. emotions you have right now. Just notice the quality of your thoughts, where the mind is. Right here, right now, bringing the awareness to the tailbone. A few more breaths here in our meditation before we begin with our flow. Bringing the awareness back into the body, back into the room. Perfect. Next inhale, gently press the palms together. And on the next inhale, gently sending the palms up overhead. Exhale, bring the palms down by your side. Next inhale, draw shoulders up to ears. And exhale, draw the shoulders down the back, gently opening the eyes. Welcome back. All right, we'll begin to warm up the body as we move into our flow. Okay, and so with that, we'll begin with a little spinal circles here, right? Just warming up the body. So if this is the first part of your day, so sending the body over to the right, you're going to inhale as you come to center. And exhale as you send it back. And we'll take two more trips around. Gratitude for the spine. Begin to notice the sensations that's happening in the low back, maybe even the hip, right? So we're activating, massaging the internal organs as well as lubricating the spine. So go ahead, take it in the opposite direction. Make sure you're inhaling at the center. Exhale when you make your trip to the back. So what we'll do now is a little bit of a toe stretch as we move into our hero's pose. So gently taking the soles, or excuse me, pressing onto the shins if you have something underneath, like your block or your pillow. So gently, firmly pressing the palms into the earth, rolling onto the shins as you lift the tailbone up, release the block, pillow, or bolster underneath you, right, or blanket. And then we come into hero's pose. So extending the legs out towards the top of the mat and sending the toes back behind you. So we'll take a little toe stretch here. So we tuck the toes right underneath. We set the tailbone back on the heels, pressing the palms down on tops of the thighs. And so you can go where it feels, go as long as it feels nice, just to stimulate, activate the meridian points underneath the soles of the feet. And if you notice that this starts to become a little bit uncomfortable or a little strenuous here, you can begin to into hero's pose. So tops of the feet on the earth as well as the shins. Again, placing the palms down right at the tops of the thighs. So the beautiful thing about yin is we don't have to rush. We get to go as far as our body allows. And each time we come to the mat, it's practice. So we get to see our body grow and stretch and move. Inhale. Perfect. On the next inhale, gently bringing your awareness back if you seem to have drifted into yoga bliss. Gently open the eyes. We'll come into butterfly pose. So transitioning here, sending the tailbone to the earth, so releasing the soles from underneath you. Now I'll turn this away so you can see me. So gently bringing the soles together. We work our way into butterfly pose as we begin to ground again, grounding into the earth. That's the purpose of the practice.
Excuse me.
Yin yoga can do that. All right. So soles of the feet, you can draw them as close to the groin as you like. Notice where you begin to feel the sensations. You can take the palms and gently cuff the toes. That feels comfortable for you, or you could just place them down on the earth. Okay. And so what we don't realize is some of the soft poses, you may feel as though sometimes you're not doing enough, and I think that's the reason that the beautiful thing to come to yoga, because the smallest movements have the biggest impact, right? So we're lengthening the spine, right? We're strengthening the spine. We're activating the groin here. Strengthening the pelvic floor. Working the psoas, the external hip. Notice where that sensation is happening. And notice your breath. Stay in contact with your breath. Never miss a moment. Inhale. Next inhale, gently reaching for your block, pillow, or bolster. If you're using a block, you want to place it on the flattest side, just placing it out in front of you. So inhale, pressing the palms into the earth as you lift the chest, the crown of the head, and begin to slowly walk the palms, right? So you can use the block as a guide to frame your palms, or you can press the forearms on the block as you recline forward or take a gentle fold. And notice what happens in the stretch, right? So maybe you begin to feel the sensations on the outside of the hip, or maybe you feel it in the low back. perfect. Gently lifting the gaze, taking the gaze to the fingertips, and slowly walking the hands back as the body comes to rise. Gently placing the block aside, block, bolster, pillow, again, whatever you're using. And we go ahead and take folded dragonfly. So we release the soles as we straddle the mat, right? Okay. And again, you can go as far as you can. Again, it should not be uncomfortable. Okay. And reaching for that block or pillow, whatever you were using, putting it out in front of you. Okay. And so inhale, reach the arms up overhead. Exhale, gently folding over the waist, right? And either option to fold onto the forearms. So maybe you're here. Maybe you're here. Maybe you're saying, Tanya, I can't, you know, I'm not moving. My body doesn't want me to. And that's okay. You still get the benefit, okay? And again, each day you come to practice, it doesn't look the same, right? So there's growth that happens. So once you found your comfortable position, you can even rest on the block. You can even rest the crown on the block if that's something you need. And as you sit in this forward fold, begin to come back to that mantra and maybe asking yourself, what does it feel like to receive, right? So exploring what may have shown up in your meditation. So again, maybe that receiving feels like guilt or shame. Maybe it feels like, you know, maybe feeling, you know, fear of receiving, right? If there's, you know, maybe there's not enough. And so we don't judge that thought, we just honor it. And so maybe we can send breath to that place and release that sensation. So inhale. Exhale. Maybe that thought sits in the hips. Maybe that thought sits, you know, in the hamstrings, right? And so also, if you notice any tightness in the hamstrings, you can always bend at the knees, okay? And we'll be here for three more breaths. Inhale. On the next inhale, gently lifting the gaze if you decided to rest the crown of the head, okay? Taking the palms and gently walking them back as the body slowly begins to rise. Okay. And so gently extend extend the legs out in front of you. Maybe you shake it out. Notice where the stretch happened and just want to invite some sensations back into the body. And so what we'll do now is we'll move into supported fish pose. So taking your block or pillow bolster, placing it on the flattest side. And so you're extending the legs out long and allowing the block or bolster to sit right at that thoracic spine as we open up the cage around the heart. This allows us to begin to receive, allowing the shoulders to cascade and gently fall over the block, resting the crown of the head on the earth. Okay, and option, if you're feeling as though you want to receive more, you can allow the palms face up, and if you want to ground, you can allow the palms to be face down. So this supportive fish supports with any allergies, sinuses, sleep apnea. This helps with better breathing of the lungs. And if you struggle with that throat chakra, right? So maybe there's soreness or swollen lymphs. Or even if you notice that, you know, you may have, you get a loss for words. This also supports opening up that throat chakra. And again, exploring where you feel the stretch in the spine. If you like, keeping the left leg extended, you can take that right sole, gently placing it on the earth. Breath, you can take the left sole, placing it on the earth, keeping the right leg extended. Maybe exploring the sensations, noticing how one side may feel a little bit different than the other. So again, not judging it, just honoring and noticing what feels different. Drifted off in yoga bliss, don't worry, we all do it. And allowing, maybe you bring both soles into the earth, right? Gently rolling onto the right side, okay? And reaching for the block pillow bolster, right, from underneath you. And allowing full spine to come in contact with the earth. Taking a moment here. Noticing what that felt like in the backside body.
perfect. Bringing both soles into the earth, walking the soles towards the tailbone, okay? And taking the block, pillow, bolster, again, whatever you're using, gently pressing firmly into the heels as you lift the hip. Take the block, place it right underneath the tailbone. Okay, so it looks like we're in bridge pose right now. What we're actually going to do is go into waterfall pose. Okay, so inhale, draw the knees into the chest. Exhale, send the soles up to the earth. To the sky. That was a different perspective. All right. So what's happening here is we take all of that oxygen, all of that blood, that chi prana, and allow it to come down through the legs, back through the body, through crown of the head. Okay. This is also good if you have challenges with lymphatic drainage, like myself. And so this flushes the body, flushes the blood. And you may notice maybe slight shaking, anything like that, movement in the legs. That's okay. It's normal. Also notice this movement can also stimulate and tone the abdomen. Here for three more breaths. Next breath, gently release these soles down, right? So knees back into chest. Exhale, gently bringing both soles into the earth. And gently pressing into the soles, lifting the hips, reaching for the block. To place it to the sides, we begin to come into the last posture, extending the legs out long, allowing the toes to fall outward, just rolling the shoulders down the back, slightly tucking the chin. Coming into the final posture. Softening the scalp. Softening the third eye. Allowing the eyes to rest in the sockets. Softening the nasal cavity. Softening the jaw. And coming back to that mantra, each time I receive abundance, I welcome it with pure gratitude and inhale. And exhale. into the body, back into the room. Wiggling the toes, wiggling the fingers. And the next inhale, gently reaching the arms up overhead, stretching the toes in the opposite direction. Slowly rolling onto your favorite side.
Perfect. Gently inhale. Pressing the palms into the earth, exhale, slowly rising to a comfortable seat. Inhale, sweeping the arms up overhead. Exhale, bringing hands down, heart center. Thank you so much for joining in with me on this beautiful grounding and gratitude practice. I hope your heart feels warm. I hope you feel grounded. A beautiful quote by the lovely Thich Nhat Hanh as he rests in peace says, "It's not the act of walking on water and not walking on air, but gratitude for walking on earth." I think that resonates. Remember to live abundantly, love your authenticity, and radiate organic happiness. But most importantly, live a life of no more trauma. Namaste.